evening and welcome to Thai PBS World Tonight. An open letter from Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha to business community during the beginning of this week. We can see welcoming response from leading business people and business associations in Thailand, as the Prime Minister said he would like to see cooperation and vision from this business community in Thailand. In the Thai PBS World Tonight, our online program, Khun Thep Chai Yong and me talk to Stanley Kang, chairman of Joint Foreign Chamber of Commerce in Thailand, to listen to foreign business community response after seeing open letter from the Prime Minister.
It's a challenging period. It's a challenging period. I think our Prime Minister has to realize it's not just how we protect our health, and also the second stage will be really challenging on the reopening map of the society and economy. And then I think the first quarter will only be hitting by the tourism business. But coming on the second quarter and fourth quarter, I believe on the exporting business, manufacturing part, we really have a very strong impact right now.
But how do you see the Prime Minister's gesture in writing open letter to leading businessmen asking for ideas and cooperation? You think it's a smart move? It's a wise move on his part?
Yeah, I think it's a very wise move because right now, in fact, it's not just a national crisis. It's also an effect on the whole world, right? And then it's totally different from just 1970s, the Dongyang Gong crisis. And then right now, personally, I believe will be very challenging for the next 18 months, right? There's a good point, there's a challenging point. And a good point is that we really have to using more new technology. Right now, we are talking, we are interviewing by long distance, the virtual way of technology. I believe that the digital life is coming to our life much faster, and not just in our life, but also our business transaction, everything. So I have to thank the government. They just changed the law to allow that we do can have the virtual conference meeting for all the AGM. But of course, that we still have a lot of like electronic sign. So I believe in the next 18 months, there's a lot of changing in our life. We got to work together and then to let our people to use to and how to implement our life into the new style.
Stanley, and if you can proposal from Foreign Chamber of Commerce, what do you like to tell, or what's the outline you like to tell the Prime Minister?
I think to protect our health is very important. So in fact, that not just with the Foreign Chamber, we work very closely with the Thai private sector, Thai Chamber of Commerce and Board of Trade. But at the same time, if we shut down too long, I believe that the economic situation will be very difficult to analyze how will that be effect. And I think you can see the figure right now from the European market and even from the United States, right? Currently, a lot of people, unemployment rate very high, and then the life have be very big impact. And then according to our study right now, and current situation that the government really have to come up with a real good policy how to help the economy. And I'm really worried that will this sentimental just for this year or even will be impact longer. And you can see the oil price even go up to the negative level. So it's a lot of things happening today and very fast. So we got to take action much faster to keep a right policy to support the private sector, to ensure that our economy don't fall into a challenging situation that we cannot put it back.
Stanley, as you just mentioned, that there is a growing call for the government to consider easing the shutdown measures, right? And as you said, I mean, the longer the shutdown lasts, the more damage it will cause to the economy. But sooner or later, the government need to make a decision on how to handle this very challenging issue. So what would be your advice as a businessman?
I think right now, we try to use the new technology and to start opening up the economic. But of course, we have to make sure that we have the capability and ability to manage the issue of COVID-19. At the same time, and then we have to make sure that we do create a job, and then we do find out what will be the new normal. I think it's a new thing, mm-hmm. not just for the private sector, also for the government. Like a lot of things that I can see the changing that from now on will be more e-government function comes up. And then and a lot of regulation that we do have to ask the government to support, right? Because in the past, we are talking about Thailand 4.0, but a lot of our regulation reform, right? Public regulation reform are still just in the Thailand 1.0, 2.0. We still require a lot of paperwork, right? Especially at the current situation. Even though we start reopening, I believe everybody to protect the health, they still have to keep the social distance. Okay. We still don't think that people can gathering back to your life normally. So a lot of application on the government document. I hope that we can see more easier on the digitalization and on the e-government part to serve the people, not just the foreign community, also the Thai local society can be getting more much convenient.
Stanley, over the weekend, there was a decree which approved electronic meetings. And do you think that will help for big corporation or can it help boost economy in Thailand?
Yes, I have to thank the government. Really have the very fast response for this one. And I think because it's a lot of our top management of the investment people in Thailand, and they have the traveling back to their country, but suddenly the country, either their country or Thailand, with the shutdown, so they cannot return to the Kingdom of Thailand on time. So if they can go to a lot of AGM or a lot of or company meeting, can relax the regulation to go through the video conference, and then that would be much help. But I think that's a good starting point. There's still a lot of things that we still hoping to see that in the next several period of months that we can make a lot of improvement on this.
Judging from what you said, I mean, it looks like we are talking about a whole new world, and it looks like we cannot go back to business as usual any longer, right? So what kind of changes do you see in the say immediate future? You talk about the need for the digitalization of the country to be accelerated. I mean, even Thailand 4.0 may not be enough. They have to be Thailand 5.0 now, right? So how do you see the immediate future of in the aftermath of the coronavirus pandemic?
Okay, basically coronavirus will take around, before the boxing come out, maybe take 12 or 18 months. No one can tell the answer yet, right? So in between this time, I don't think that any country will just open its country so easily, right? And we hope can be open, but maybe it takes time because the health are still very important, right? And so I give example. In the past, we do traveling very easy. We have a lot of airline, either the low cost air to the normal airline. But I don't think in the future you will have a lot of people traveling around that often. So a lot of new way of communication is coming up. So the new way of communication will change our business behavior, our lifestyle. An example, can we open a school right now? A lot of people are worrying, right? The elder student are still okay. The younger student, is that good for them to long distance learning? And if not, if we open school, how we take care of the health? So a lot of things that we are all learning together.
That's the view from President of Joint Foreign Chamber of Commerce in Thailand. And that brings us to the end of Thai PBS World Tonight.